Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So I just did my foundation off camera because this tutorial doesn't have any different foundation technique. So I just applied my powder and foundation trick. And you know the deal, the hair is gonna be up because it is freaking hot and I am annoyed. So yeah, a lot of you guys wanted to see a foxy eye tutorial. It is not something which is new or anything of that sort. It's been a trend which is going on since a while, but it has been really hyped, and also because it looks really beautiful. It just elevates and lifts your face so well. It looks very, very beautiful. Few of the people who carry foxy eye makeup looks a lot are Bella Hadid, Kendall Jenner, and even Patrick Ta, like, you know, does these foxy eye type of looks a lot, and it looks really, really beautiful. And you guys wanted a tutorial. So many of you DM me, ki do this or we'll kill you. I'm like, chill bro, whenever you want and you have any recommendation, you can definitely DM me. Like, I make these videos for you guys. So let's get into the video. We'll start with our eyes and then complete our base. So foxy eye tutorial is more about that cat eye look, that very lifted, snatched type of look. Usually, you know, all these people, Kendall or Bella, probably have like Botox or you know, brow lifts or something of that sort. So you know, they're like, they naturally have that lift right here, but we're going to do that with makeup. So let's take an eyebrow pencil. This is the Sugar Cosmetics eyebrow pencil. This is the Arc Arrival Sugar Cosmetics pencil. So I have my brows right here, but usually what they have is a brow which is lifted right here. So usually people shave off the brow till here so that, you know, they get that lifted look, but I don't have the guts to shave my eyebrow. I want to really do something like, you know, which lifts, because this matters a lot. This kind of lifts the face really well, but we're going to try and do that with makeup today. I'm just taking the brow pencil, and we have to make sure we are going to lift the brow right here. Just brush all the brows up and fill it properly. This look is kind of going to look like the Eid look I just did, but that was more like, you know, a vibrant type of smoky eye black winged look. But compared to that, this is going to be a little more subtle. People usually give others so much crap for doing any cosmetic procedure like brow lift, Botox, fillers. Like, get a life, dude. If it's not your face, what is your problem? Next, I'm just using an old mascara. It's like literally dried out. So, you know, you can use this as a brow, what do you call?
2 hours later.
So you can use this as a brow mascara or anything, you know, it's just going to keep everything in place. You can see, like, you know, compared to this, this side looks so neat because of this mascara, and you know, this is going to look better a lot with this. It's literally dried out mascara. It's a very old mascara, so it's a really good trick. Like, how you're done with your mascara, or if your mascara is expired and there's very little left in it, you can use this. You cannot use a fresh mascara, obviously, because it's going to be really harsh. Like, you know, it's going to look really weird. But if you have something which is dried out and there's nothing much left in it, you can just do this. Next step is to carve out the brow. This is also a really important step, you know, to give that lift to the brow. You need to make sure the ends are always lifted and up. So I'm just taking a little concealer. So I'm just going to apply the same concealer all over the lid. So now what we have to do is, it's all about color placement. Like, you know, you have to make sure you lift your eyes using colors. So we're just going to take a really soft brown like this one. I'm using the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette. So just take a really soft brown and just mixing these two shades. You cannot like just draw a random line to lift your eyes up. Just make sure you follow your lower lash line. So your lower lash line is in this direction. So wherever it's ending, start the shadow from there. This is going to give you a lift. So you can see I actually did my brow also in that angle. Like, I forgot to mention that. So this and this, this is how you, you know, lift your eye look according to, you know, your eye, whichever is that angle, place the color right there. Don't worry if your, you know, shadow is a little out of place. You can, anyways, didn't do your base, so you can wipe it off later. just adding this color, building it up. Don't take it till the inner corner, just keep it until the center of the lid. And I'm just going to take that lightly on the crease as well, because I like having definition on my crease. From here on, we are going to build it up with deeper colors. Now after this, I'm going to just take a little bit of dark brown. So I'm going to go in with this and this, just taking a touch of these two and placing this closer to the lash line. Now the previous brown we placed all over just to build definition. This is going to be more precise. Next, I'm just going to take even more deeper brown and place it closer. You can see, right, it just gave that slight lift. I usually do this when I'm just going, like, you know, that's like a part of my go-to makeup glam as well. I don't do such a harsh line, but I do take bronzer and just draw that line. Gives me a lift to the eyes, like, you know, that very faux eye where it's there, not there, you know, you're kind of fooling the eye with the light type of look. So that's it, just a very soft line. I'm just taking that same thing on the other side as well. Want, you can just take a fluffy brush and just, you know, blend it a little more so that, you know, you don't have any harsh edges or anything of that sort. It's going to blend everything really well. Next, what you can do is to enhance this look more, you can take something like this, a very, like, you know, a powder shade which matches your skin tone, and just apply it in the center just to give that subtle finished look. It's going to clean up the area more to give you a little more lift. You can even take white if you want, but I wanted to keep it, like, you know, as soft as possible. So I'm just taking this shade which kind of matches my eyelid color to give that very soft, like, look. That shade kind of faded away, so I'm just going to add it a little more. Finally, let's just take a little bit of black and line the lid very closely. Just take a precise brush. It's way easier to blend with the powder black. So, just adding that on the lid. Now, after doing all that, when I look straight, I do have a curve right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a line. So always make sure you lift your eyes and see after opening your eyes how the lift is looking. So I think I just need a little brown right here. So yeah, perfect. So now that outer lid part is done, we still have to do the foxy inner corner and everything. But before that, I just want to clean off. Now, if this is the time, if you have any mistakes or anything of that sort, just clean it off. I don't really see a lot of mistakes, but if I wipe this off, it's just going to give me a more precise look. So I'm just going to do that. Next, just apply concealer. Now, applying concealer also plays a huge role in how your look pops. So you need to make sure you drag the concealer all the way till here to give you that very nice and lifted look. So I'm just going to apply concealer. Normally, first, I'm using the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind. Now, if you have a doe foot applicator to your concealer, it's easier to apply, like, straight outside. But I don't. So I'm just taking a brush, concealing and lifting the look right here with the concealer. So this is just going to give you that lift you need for the look with the concealer. So you can see that concealer just gave so much lift. I don't want it to be so harsh. I'm just going to slightly blend it and make it look a little soft. Like, I'm not going to remove the definition, but just a little bit of blending. Anyway, that's going to look a little even once we do our inner corner and the lower lash line. So next, we're just going to go in with the same browns we took initially and place it on the outer edge of the lower lash line. Don't get it to the inner corner. Just on the outer, joining the top and the bottom to give a little definition. That's it. Don't bring it too much inside. Now go ahead and blend this out. Enjoy the top lid and the bottom lid. So now you can see it is just lifted from the lower lash line to the up. That's how it's supposed to look. Now we just have to do that inner foxy eye. I'm just taking my brow pencil, this is the color bar, and draw that almond shape eye. I usually don't like that look for my eye because I do have a circular kind of thing going on in my inner corner. So I just drag it a little corner. I'm just again taking brown and going to enhance that a little more. See, that's how it's supposed to look. Just follow your lash line and just draw a small little V to give you that eye shape. Now we are almost done. We just have to highlight a little. I'm going to take this and this and going to highlight the inner corner a lot. So I'm just going to place, now normally I place my highlighter here in the inner corner, but I do have that foxy eye going on. So I'm just going to place the highlighter right above it for, you know, my eye to shine. See, look at that. That just instantly made so much difference for the eye. So I'm just going to blend that in a little. Just toning it down a little because I don't want it to be too strong. Highlighter makes huge role on tricking your eye where to look. So again, I'm going to lift the brows using a little bit of highlighter. I'm just going to use on the brow bone a little. Let's just quickly finish our bronzer, highlighter, etc. And we'll move on to the lashes as well. Now you want to lift your face, so make sure you apply your bronzer right here where you kind of lift your cheekbones a lot and give you that, you know, chisel and snatch look. Now I'm just going to take a crease brush and join the color in and the nose. I'm just joining the brows, the nose and the crease just to give a lot of dimension. And hitting on the high points of my cheek. So just concentrate the mascara a lot on the outer edges. So for lashes, you need to make sure they are really wispy on the outer edges. Or you can just chop off any lash and just place that on the outer portion of your lid. Pack M72 lashes are really beautiful lashes. They have that thin inner corner, but you know, very wispy, like not extremely wispy, that very natural lashes. So I'm not finding those lashes right now, so I'm just going in with the Pack 53 lash. It's a very natural lash. I'm just going to make sure I place it very you know, high on the outer edge, and that's how you're supposed to place your lash always anyway. So I'm just going to place those lashes and I'll be right back. So lashes are on, they look really nice and wispy. You can see they did give a lift to the look as well. And now I'm just going to go in with the blush. We just have blush and lip and we are done. So I'm just going to take Coral Climax from Sugar Cosmetics and lightly apply it. Love applying the blush on my nose as well. So just to like clean it up a little more, I'm taking the, you know, same bronzer I used. I'm taking the lighter shade and just going to dab it around the eye area to give it, brighten it a little more and highlight that area. So let's move on to the lips quickly. This is the Eleger lip liner in hazelnut. I just added this Faces Canada lip pencil in the shade Hazel on the lips, a very coral color. Now one more tip, if you want to just make that eye more lifted, is you can just take this part of your hair wherever your eyes are ending, pull this up and clip it on the back side. Like, make sure you're ready for headache because obviously it's going to put a lot of stress. But you know, if you want for pictures or anything of that sort, you can like definitely, you know, pull this hair up. This is going to give you an instant lift. Like, look at that lift, dude. It's like crazy. I just pull all this hair, you can see how much it's getting lifted. If I leave, it's like this. If I pull, it's like this. So if you want that lift, you can do that with your hair as well. Already the makeup will enhance that even more. So yeah guys, that's it for today's video. And if you enjoyed the video, if you liked the video, then make sure you like, share, subscribe, comment. It'll mean the world to me. And ring the notification bell so that you get notified every time I post. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.